Hi guys, I'm Randy, and today on BRS TV, we're helping you size, set up, and maintain the very affordable and high-quality Reef Octopus Varios DC pump for your tank. In today's video, we'll discuss some of the main features of these very popular controllable return pumps, show you what they come with, and walk through the steps to get one installed and running on your aquarium in no time. With its easy-to-use and intuitive controller that doesn't require a ton of instructions to operate, four different size options which are very silent with varying flow rates that cover pretty much all the most popular tank sizes, as well as unique features like an included float switch for built-in pump protection or two choices for feed or maintenance modes, it's easy to see why the Reef Octopus Varios pumps gets awesome customer reviews and why they are some of the most commonly selected DC return pumps used by the BRS team. On top of that, the Varios pumps have onboard 0 to 10 volt control capability and is Apex ready, meaning that Neptune has certified them to be fully compatible and optimized for control through their Apex aquarium controller and cloud-based Apex Fusion interface. Finally, the super small footprint of the Varios 2 makes it an ideal choice for those who are space limited or choose to use multiple return pumps on their systems for lower maintenance and additional layers of protection and redundancy. These DC-powered Varios pumps are designed specifically for standard installs where the pump is directly below or next to the tank, like in a sump inside the stand. If you're thinking of installing your pump in the basement or longer than normal plumbing runs, you may want to give a quick glance at the flow charts for each pump to see if it'll fit your needs. When sizing a pump for your tank, typically reefers aim for pumps that will provide around 10 times the total water volume for turnover rate through the entire system, knowing that the actual pump output could be anywhere between 25 to 50% less due to things like head pressure loss from vertical plumbing runs as well as from multiple plumbing fittings, meaning that actual turnover is often 5 times to 7 times after the head pressure loss is calculated. With that in mind, it's a good rule of thumb to select a pump rated for slightly higher than the 10 times turnover calculation, meaning that for a 100-gallon tank, a pump capable of a minimum of 1,000 gallons per hour may work, but ideally a pump that's 20% higher, around 1,200 gallons, would be a better fit. That means the Varios 2 is a good choice for tanks up to 65 gallons, the Varios 4 should support tanks up to 90 gallons, Varios 6 for tanks upwards of 125 gallons, while the largest of the four, the Varios 8, should have you covered on tanks all the way up to 220 gallons. Past that, it's best to run a dual pump configuration with one for each return line, and if you find yourself somewhere in the middle or unsure which one to get, we strongly suggest saving yourself some frustration by choosing the larger option, which proportionally isn't much more, keeping in mind that you can always tune a larger pump down, but it's not possible to tune a smaller pump up. Looking at what comes with the Varios pumps, each of them include a majority of the same parts and accessories with subtle differences in the sizes for the plumbing fittings as well as the pump body dimensions for the Varios 2 versus the 4, 6, and 8. With each pump, you'll get the Varios controller that measures just under 4¾ inches long without the float switch attached, right at 2¾ inches tall and a little over 1¼ inches thick, as well as a mounting bracket with mounting hardware. You'll also get the optional float switch assembly with a sturdy and adjustable mount. The cables from the pump to the controller are all about 6 feet long, and although there are small differences in the sizes of the drivers for each pump, generally the power supply cable should be able to reach around 9.5 feet. Lastly, each of the Varios pumps come with a white protective screen for the pump's inlet, which snap together and screw onto the intake side of the pump for use internally. The pump sizes and included plumbing fittings differ slightly amongst the four pumps, with the Varios 2 pump body measuring just about 5 inches long, 3 inches wide, and a little over 4 inches tall, while the Varios 4, 6, and 8 are all the same size and come in slightly larger at around 5¾ inches long, 3¾ inches wide, and about 5¼ inches tall. For the included plumbing fittings, the Varios 2 comes with two 1-inch unions for the input and output, as well as a stepper barb fitting for 1/2-inch and 3/4-inch soft tubing. The Varios 4 has 1-inch and 1¼-inch unions with the same 1/2- and 3/4-inch step barb. The Varios 6 uses 2-inch-and-a-quarter unions with a step barb for 3/4-inch and 1¼-inch tubing, and the Varios 8 comes with 2-inch-and-a-quarter unions with a single 1-inch-and-a-quarter barbed fitting. Physical installation of the Reef Octopus Varios pump should only take a few minutes to mount the controller, plumb the pump to your system with PVC or soft plumbing, and turn it on, but here are some tips to help make the installation process go smooth. If you opt to hard plumb the pump to your tank, it's easiest to utilize the included unions, which can make it very quick to remove later if needed for things like pump maintenance. Whether hard plumbing internally or externally, you will want to install the included O-rings into the unions to create a leak-free seal. With that, if you choose the soft plumbing option, there's also a flat rubber gasket included with the pump that you'll want to install between the barbed fitting and the pump output, then secure it with the collar. With the pump plumbed in and ready to go, let's walk through the included Varios controller, as well as briefly touch on using the pump with the Neptune Apex controller. When you first power on the controller, you'll see the blue speed indicator LEDs light up, which you can change with the plus or minus button until the flow matches your desired speed. In addition to the plus or minus speed control buttons, you'll also see a pause button that will turn the pump off for either 15 or 60 minutes. You can toggle between the 15 or 60 minute option by pressing the pause button again, as well as cancel the pause mode by pressing the power button and turn the pump back on. Either way, whether you cancel the mode or let the timer run, the pump will automatically resume its last set speed, meaning that you can walk away from the pump and know that it will resume pumping on its own. The last button you'll see is labeled FS, which stands for float switch, and tells your controller whether or not to respond to the float switch when it's turned on or off. When the status light is on, for example, when the water is dropped below your desired level, the pump will shut down, preventing any potential damage from the pump running dry, and then resume normal operation when the water level rises. Here's a couple of notes about the float switch modes. You do have to keep the FS mode off when the float switch is not installed in order for your pump to work. Conversely, if you opt to use the float but you don't want the pump to shut down while messing with the tank, you can simply toggle the FS mode off until you're done. Lastly, if you're connecting the pump to the variable speed ports on the Neptune Apex, you will need a separate 0 to 10 volt cable like this one from IceCap in order to connect them together. Once connected, you can find the correct variable speed outlet, typically labeled VAR speed 1, 2, 3, or 4, drag it down to your dashboard and verify it's the right one by toggling it on and off, which should turn your pump on and off. With that done, I like to rename the outlet something like Varios underscore pump, and I'm ready to program it. There are a few options to program the Varios, like using the tasks function or configuration page, but most will use the programming wizard that allows you to drag and drop various speed points throughout the day. One thing to note here, as with most gear with 0 to 10 volt control, there is a minimum percentage where the pump will actually power on. That's not always from 0 to 1%. So with the Varios pump, it's recommended to start any programming at 15% or higher. Maintaining our reef gear is always best practice to get the longest life and best performance overall. And since the return pump is one of the most important parts of the life support of our tanks, there are some steps we can take to keep them running in top shape as well. With that in mind, it's not likely you'll need to service your Varios pump more than a couple of times a year, which is super easy with some citric acid or vinegar and water. Dropping the pump in a bucket of one of these solutions and letting it run for a few minutes should easily take care of most buildup. However, for deeper cleaning, you can remove the pump's volute and impeller to clean with a soft brush. Removing the volute requires no tools at all, and all you have to do is remove the base, rotate the volute counterclockwise, and pull it off. With the volute off, you can pull out the magnetic impeller, allowing you to clean it even further. The Varios pumps include pretty much everything you need to have it pushing water in your tank in no time. However, there are a couple of optional accessories you can use with them. If you have a Neptune Apex, you could pick up a flow monitoring kit or individual flow sensor to help you monitor the amount of flow from the Varios pump, which can alert you if flow rates are higher or lower than your normal operating range, which may be an indication that the pump needs to be maintained. Lastly, if you choose to plumb your tank with silicone tubing or braided vinyl, you can use one of these spigot by barbed fittings with the included unions for a more robust connection that still allows you to take advantage of the quick and easy removal. Thanks for watching, and if you have any more questions that we didn't answer here, feel free to give us a call, send us an email, or hop on a chat. See you next time on BRS TV.